What reports should you be watching in your CRM? See, I like to measure specifically two different reports, the 90-day did not contact list and the lost deals list. Those are great starting points if you're looking for low-hanging fruit. Yes, it's wonderful if you get a brand new prospect who is ready to buy right now. But what do you do if your sales funnel starts to run dry? Where do you start to go and rehash anything that might not have been able to close before? Your 90-day did not call list are clients that you have been in contact with, but you haven't reached out to in a while. A lot of things have changed in 3 months, and now is a great time to consistently stay on top of those prospects. See, it takes 5 sales calls in order to close 80% of prospects. 5. And can you say with a certain level of guarantee that you have contacted every one of those prospects at least 5 times? For most of us, that's probably not. And if that's not the case, then we either have to do one of two things. Get them completely off your list. They're not a prospect. Remove them. Or say, yes, it's time to re-engage. Yes, it's time to find out if there's something new with them. The other list I like to look at is the lost deals list. These are the people that were so close. They were so close, and for whatever reason, timing or revenue, budget, something had disappeared on their radar. And for whatever reason, we decided to close them out. Get back in touch with them. Continue to keep the conversation going. Find out if something has changed, because something might have. They got this close, they are likely to get this close again. And if not, it is what it is. But those are the ones that I would go after if I were you. Let me know in the comments. Did you try calling on somebody in your 90-day did not call list? Did you try re-engaging with somebody in your closed lost sales cycle? And if so, what was the result? We want to help you become a sales knockout.